You're next. Right, let's have a look at Roscoe. Gold Coast comments from last week, mate. Let's hear what you had to say and what Tony Cochrane, the chairman, had to say.
If we just drill into Gold Coast, are they, for what we've pumped in, are we getting return on investment there? Do you put in hibernation? One less club, you could have a 32-game season, put marquee games up and service southeast Queensland and really establish it and then maybe bring it out of hibernation and go again.
The AFL Commission have done 10 years of hard slog using the media rights fee money to get us into this position. And why anybody would even consider chopping that growth off now just proves that perhaps not only are they a failed coach, but they don't know much about economics either. Enough's enough. Go find another topic. We are off the agenda.
At the risk of being self-promotional and self-indulgent on Footy Classified tonight, that was a particularly nasty drive-by.
Well, I've had a few drive-bys in a year. I'm glad he stood up for his club, but if there's an oil spill, there's an oil spill, which Gillon McLachlan's acknowledging. The AFL's in a financial fight of its life. He didn't shy away from that. We'll come back, hopefully, this year in the same structure and form and finish the year. But from then, we're going to fight on our hands here. So we were just brainstorming and looking, is there a different way to serve northeast Queensland and increase the growth of football as opposed to the Brisbane Lions and the Gold Coast Suns?
So
and I think it's a reasonable question.
Still, do you still believe that hibernating the Gold Coast?
I was brainstorming. I didn't say it's the solution. I said it's one. But I think, which I said, and I responded in another medium, Tony needs to be careful. If you want to apply the lens of a premiership and make a binary failure, well, if he applies that lens and puts it on himself internally and his club, it's clear what the picture is. So don't apply that to an AFL coach. And then you're an AFL club, and you want to talk about participation rates that AFL Queensland grow. Brisbane Lions and Bears have been growing since 86, and it's funded out of the AFL as well on top of, and grab the 5.2% for yourself and talk about community ovals. That's not your measure as an AFL club. We were just looking at, and I think their real problem is, as a football person, they were put in a year before GWS with all the advantages, all the allowances. And one's got 30,000 members, been in a prelim and a grand final. And the other one, we're still sitting here really concerned and asking for further concessions. And I think if you add to that, with soft cap being reduced, the first clubs that are going to need the assistance to stay are going to be those that need to retain their junior talent that they're bringing in, the Rouse and the Anderson. I think Gold Coast are going to need to ask for extra allowance again. So it was just a topic of discussion. But I like his fight, no problem.
The only thing I would say is with footy, NRL footy, in so much trouble at the moment, more trouble than the AFL, Ed, I think that the AFL see a golden opportunity in making, and we discussed this briefly last week, New South Wales and Queensland are a far more vulnerable market now for the AFL to try and conquer, or at least get some inroads into.
As they say in the stockbroking terms, they don't ring the bell at the bottom of the market or the top to let you know. So when do you actually go to make your money? And people have to remember the Gold Coast area in that Brisbane area has more people than South Australia, West Australia, Tasmania, Northern Territory combined in that area, and it's a growth industry. If AFL football owns the east coast of Australia, then it owns Australia because we've got South Australia, got the other areas. Those two areas are pivotal, but once again, to Ross's point, and I'm trying to be a mediator here because we are, as you said, Gareth, everything's on the table.
OK, you're not a mediator now.